Hello everyone, this is Erlin from the Experience Research Lab. Today I'll show you how to read the output of correspondence analysis in SPSS. In this video, I'll use an example file household.sep. The dataset has 5 variables. The first 2 variables, ID and weight, are numeric and use scales. The 2 variables in the middle, life stage and internet access, are nominal. Meanwhile, the last one, household income, is ordinal. For your information, in the previous video where I ran the correspondence analysis, I picked up several problems with the variables. You can check the video later, but I have highlighted the problems and solutions here. The third variable, life stage, should have had 6 categories instead of 5. 1 for the young independents, 35-year-old or less, 2 for the singles, 3 for the married with no children, 4 for the young families, 35-year-old or less, 5 for the old families, 36-year-old or more, and 6 for the old independents, 36-year-old or more. Meanwhile, the last variable, household income, the categories should have been 1 for $30,000 or less, 2 for $30,001 to $50,000, 3 for $50,001 to $100,000, and 4 for $100,001 or more. But this is only a note to keep in the background of your mind. For today, I will use the dataset with the existing categorization anyway. To measure the relative relationship between life stage and household income, I have configured a setting for the statistics and plots. For the statistics, I have set SPSS to display the correspondence table. Additionally, I also want to have the overview of the row and the column points. Meanwhile, for the plots, I choose to go with the bioplot. I don't want SPSS to restrict the number of dimensions. Instead, I want it to display all in the solutions. I click continue, then I click OK. So this is how the output of correspondence analysis looks. At a glance, the first table, the correspondence tables, looks like the crosstab I created in the other video. The difference is that if the crosstab had the life stage in the row and household income in the column, the correspondence tables displays the transpose version here. The life stage in the column and the household income in the row. Another difference, and this is the most important to note, is that if the crosstab only included the valid cases, the correspondence table here takes all cases, including the ones with missing values, into account. Now let us continue to the summary table. In the leftmost column, there are 3 dimensions. It is the maximum number that SPSS can present here. The maximum number of dimensions depend on the numbers of the categories in each variables and the equality constraints. In the absence of equality constraints like in this analysis, the number of dimensions equals the number of categories in the variables with the fewest option minus 1. Life stage has 5 categories, while household income has 4. Therefore, the maximum number of dimensions here is 4 minus 1 equals 3. Out of these 3 dimensions, the first shows the highest singular value. Combined with the second one, both account for 98.7% of the total inertia. Adding the 3rd dimension does not make a significant difference as it only contributes 1.3% to the inertia. Considering this, I can decide to go with a 2-dimensional representation. The 3rd table, an overview of row points, shows the contributions of each attribute in variable household income. Household income lower than $30,000 and more than $100,000 contribute the most to the inertia of the first dimension. On the other side, the household income of between $30,000 and $100,000 are the main contributors to the inertia of the second dimension. 2 dimensions contribute significantly to the inertia of all row points. The first dimension makes nearly equal significant contributions to all row points, except household income between $50,001 to $100,000, whose representation is actually better in the second dimension. The 4th table, an overview of column points, shows the contributions of each attribute in variable life stage. The older family makes the highest contributions to the inertia of the first dimension. Meanwhile, the older independents contribute the most significant portion to the inertia of the second dimension. 2 dimensions contribute significantly to the inertia of all column points, except the young family. The first dimension contributes significantly to the older family, singles or married with no children, and the independents. It means that these 3 points or three categories are well represented here. The second dimension contributes most to the older independents. Now let us check the bioplot to see how the life stage related to household income. Dividing the inertia equally over both the rows and columns, this plot shows the distances between the categories of the two variables. Looking at this plot, I can say that the singles or married with no children are most frequently associated with household income between $50,001 and $100,000. Meanwhile, the older family are most frequently associated with household income under $30,000. How about the independents and the older ones? Are they similar like I asked in the previous video? It is still difficult to tell. The only thing I can safely say about these two categories is that they are somewhat different. The independents are more frequently associated with the highest household income of more than $100,000, while the older ones are more often associated with the lower income between $30,001 and $50,000. It is also important to note that the association between the older independent with low household income is not as strong as the relationship between the singles or the married ones and higher income. Last but not least, this output might be different if the two variables, life stage and household income, use the proposed categories. So life stage has 6 categories and household income has 4. On that note, I will put an end to this video here. For more insights into data, including data entry, data transformations, and data analysis, especially in SPSS, please subscribe, listen, and watch our content. It is available in text, audio, and video format. Thank you for being with me today. I'll see you next time in the other videos. Cheers.